बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन एंड आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर स्टडिंग एट होम एंड गिविंग ड्यू टाइम टू योर स्टडीज। सो लास्ट टाइम वी वर गोइंग थ्रू Zainab, you want to drawing on my screen? If I forgot to close the annotation, so what does it mean? You people are going to draw images, draw lines on my screen. Okay, so what we are going to do today, we are going to explore in the same chapter, and we had done some exercise work. Saad Fayaz, I have already forwarded your case, okay? Inshallah, you'll get your ID and password. So, yesterday I had given you the homework over there in your university. So today again we have to see the homework because we have another homework for today. So first, I think all of you should note down the homework that I'm going to put in your university. Just see, you are going to receive this is homework 2 for this chapter that we are going through. So today I am going to give you from the same chapter, chapter number 10. Last time I had given you one question only. So today we are going to have the descriptive part of this question, and only I think two portion are enough for the descriptive question as well. First we go to the book and we see that what are the questions written over here. Okay, in descriptive question, the question is that how can you identify a Cree frame in the timeline? How can you identify a keyframe in the timeline? Number one point is this. And the second one is write keyboard shortcuts to insert a frame and a keyframe. Write keyboard shortcut to insert a frame and a keyframe. Okay, so this is the first part of the first question of the descriptive question. I am going to make it red. Okay, this is the question, and the answer is, you can see on your screen, the black dot in the timeline indicate basically the keyframe, and the shortcut are basically F5 and F6. F5 to insert a frame and F6 to insert a keyframe. So this is a question that I am going to put over there. Very short piece of work that I am going to give you. That you need to write in your notebook. This is the question and this is the answer for this question. Start and end date for submission tomorrow. Okay. You are going to have a notification as well, and you are going to receive this work in your university. I hope you are able to see. You will receive one notification about it. Fine. Okay. So this is the homework, a very short homework, two line homework that I have given you, and I will also give the same in your Google Classroom. All these students will keep the cameras closed. So over here, I have also pasted the same work over here as well. Okay. In today's date. Fine. So I will, after completion of this video, I will upload the video as well. So right now I'm not clicking on the post, but it will be given to you. Okay. Yes, Yasir, you want to ask something? Yasir Badr.
Hello.
Yes, Yasir. What is this? Haider Sultan. Haider, have you got any question? I have unmuted you. You have raised the hand. Heather, your voice is not coming to us. Okay. So you need to check the mic. Your voice is not coming. Fine. Yes, Maida.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Walaikum salam. Yes, please.
Sir, I have submitted my the activity that you have given F part.
Okay, that F part of the exercise of this lesson.
Yes.
Okay, fine. Three students have only submitted in yesterday. Two we have already seen. So we can also see this one. So whenever next time anyone is submitting, so you should submit the published file, exported for file, that is .avi file. Okay. Let me check this one that Maida has sent us. Good. One car is coming. and it is getting stopped at the red, and when yellow and then green is going to switch on, then the car is moving ahead. Now this is a good animation, you know, but one problem is there, the road is also moving at some frame there is a bit problem, but I think it is overall it is good. And how many layers you have taken? You have taken two layers. One layer is there on which all the students keep the cameras closed. One layer is there where road is there, and on one layer I think car is moving. Yes, okay, fine. Fine, overall it is a good animation. Yes, Heather, you want to ask something? Heather, you have checked the mic. Yes, I have unmuted you. No, there is no particular voice. Okay, you check and then raise hand. Mohammed Safi.
Sir, I have submitted my yesterday homework, and can you tell that are you done with the attendance?
Sorry, for attendance, what you are asking?
Sir, I am done with my homework which you give yesterday, and I also wanted to ask that are you done with the attendance?
No, still not. Okay, if you have submitted, fine, but main objective is that you have to write in your in the notebook. Okay, keep in mind. Rimsha is here.
Sir, I just came now. Can you mark me present?
Still, attendance is not done. I am going to mark the attendance. It does not matter. Muazzam Tahir. Yes, you have raised the hand. Your voice is not coming, Muazzam. Loudly. There is some voice issue. I am unable to listen to you. Mohammed Zain.
Assalamualaikum sir.
Waalaikum salam. Yes. Yes, quickly.
I want to ask that sir, jo assignments aap de rahe activities inke marks lagenge?
No.
Okay sir.
Keep in mind that in the life everything is not for the marks. Some things are there that we do for our skill development. Okay. If the marks are there, then you will do. If the marks are not there, then you will not do. No, this logic is not good. Okay. Come to the chapter, and we have to see the lab activities over here. I am not going to take any more question right now. When I will, then I will let you know. Okay. Draw a scenery and convert it into a symbol. This is for this chapter number 10. Draw a scenery and convert it into a symbol and use it as a background in an animation where a bird flying from one tree to another. What does it mean? Means that there would be some scenery and you don't need to take the scenery from the Google image. No, you have to draw the scenery. What is the word written over here? You have to draw it to your own. Means it is the exam of your drawing, that how much you are good at the drawings. Convert it to symbol. Now what could be there in the scenery? There would be some, you know, trees, or you know, some mountains or plants, something like that. Then we have to use that scenery as a background in any other animation. And then what we are going to do, we can use in any animation that scenery. For example, in the same scenery, one bird is flying, sitting on a tree and flying to another tree, going towards another tree. So this thing we can do. And what we have to do first is objective is basically to make a scenery and convert it to the symbol. So how first we will take some idea about how a scenery basically looks like. What may be different components inside the scenery? Scenery, natural scenery. Okay. So I have written over here scenery drawing, and we can search it over there over the internet. You can find out a number of drawings are there for the scenery, just like this one, but we are not going to take this as it is by taking the image. No, we have to draw it. What does it mean? That we are going to draw it. So you can take any model of the scenery and you can draw it. So I will give this assignment as well in your Google Classroom, so that when people have done, so they will submit it to me. Okay, when you have done, so you are going to submit to me. Fine. I don't think so there is any sort of issue in it, and you can draw it quite easily. You can draw the trees, you can draw the plants, you can draw different types of objects which are available inside a scenery, and then you can use that scenery in any of your animations. Okay, just like over here, you can see that trees are there, the houses are there, and the plants are also there. Grassy area is, some grassy area is there, and one boat is there which is going on over there in this picture. So similarly, see, there are some different types of for example, we take this one. This is the scenery where we have got some mountains, plants, grassy areas, trees, one house, okay, and the water field is there. So how we can draw such kind of scenery in Flash? So for this purpose, of course, we need to have some good drawing work. It all depends on your interest and on your work experience, how much you are good at. So we can draw the lines by pencil, we can draw the mountains by brush tool as well, directly by the brush tool, or we can draw the mountains by pencil and then we can fill them. It's up to us that how we are going to draw this type of scenery. Okay. So over here, what I'm going to do, I can take the pencil tool to draw the mountains. As I have told you, that basically depends on your hands, on practice, and how much you are good at drawings. You cannot fill any object until it is not closed. So over here, just like we can see over here that that some grassy areas are also there. So we can draw the grass as well, and then we can make an enclosed shape in the mountains. So how we can draw the grass? We can take the pencil in some dark green or green color, and we can give some effect of the grassy areas, that this is some kind of grassy area available over here. And with the grassy area, you can attach. Now this is an enclosed shape. If some shape is not closed, for example, this line, so you can make it closed as well, okay? For example, if you want to make it close, you can make it close in this way by dragging it. For example, this corner is not closed. You can pick it, you bring the mouse cursor before selection and just attach to this. then it will be closed. So in this way, we can make the images closed. Why we are making it closed? Because if it will be closed, then you are going to fill it with some color. Just like the mountains are normally in gray color. So now we can fill this using gray color. This is possible for us to fill it. Okay. For example, how do we fill it? We take the parent bucket tool and we go and select some color, just like this gray color, and we can fill this color. Okay, this is a gray color that we have filled. But if it was not closed, if the corners of the mountains were open, then we were not able to do this. Okay, now I take the, let's suppose I take brush tool, I take some dark green color brush tool, and in dark green color I draw some things over here. Okay, so I can fill it in this way as well, or by taking some light color. I can fill it in this way as well, or I can fill using parent bucket tool. If it is a closed image, keep in mind, then we can take some green color and we can drop it over here. In this way as well, we can fill it to create effect like grass. Okay. Now another way of making grass is that you take the pencil tool and increase the thickness of the pencil tool. Just like you click on the pencil tool in green color, take the thickness in some 2 or 3 points and then draw it at yourself. So in this way as well, you can draw the effect of the grass by making multiple lines and by making their multiple copies over in each other. Okay, so in this way, you can also draw the grass by drawing multiple lines and by, but you can fill it using this way as well. Okay, we make the trees also in this way, that draw some design of the tree, for example. Okay, and draw a stem for this tree. Take a brown color. Draw a closed stem for the tree. Now we can fill it with some color, or with the same color, just like this color is there right now. If I want to take the same color, I will copy this color, Control C, I will go there and I will paste it over here, Control V, and then I can take the fill box and I can fill the same inside. So if you take the pencil and if you fill it, how we can take the color using eyedropper tool? If you miss the color, go there, click using eyedropper tool, you will be able to take the color. Now you can fill this tree randomly, or by drawing something, or you can make it as whatever you want. And then you can make an effect of the tree. Of course, in the drawings, it depends on your working, on your capacity, that how much you are good at drawing. So if you will give a due time to it, you will be able to make a proper drawing of this. For example, normally we make one small pattern and we copy that pattern inside a number of times. This is a common strategy that normally we use, just like in this way, by making multiple copies of it. Okay, now you can make the same tree by making its copies. You can make the same tree and you can resize it. You can resize it. I had explained you the other ways as well to draw a tree. tree. For example, this is a tree that I have made. I can make it in small size and I can make multiple copies of the tree. Okay, so in this way you can draw different designs and of course it depends on you that how you are going to draw. You will take the water, you will take the hut, see the designs of the hut over here, just like they have given you different designs. You can draw such kind of tree as well, just like this one. You can draw this one as well. First, you will make just this top of this tree and then you will make its copies and you will be able to draw this kind of tree. Using line tool or using pencil tool, you can draw the hut. Okay, so now I'm going to mark the attendance. Then what you have to do, you have to make one scenery. And you have to submit in your Google Classroom. All these students just lower the hand, those who have raised. I will take the question, don't worry. Let me mark the attendance. From Haris Khan to Amina Mustafa, then Jaisir, then Muhammad Tahir, then Sunil Shehbaz, okay, so yes, please. Have you got any question? Kindly, please ask. Those who want to ask. Yes, Heather.
Sir, can you hear me now?
Yes, please. Yes, now your voice is clear now.
Because it is another computer.
There was some issue. That's why I was saying that you were speaking. But no voice was coming. Okay, now yes, please.
The thing that there was something you sent it on our email, like go through it or answer the question, but I didn't understand it.
I had explained that question in the previous classes. It was basically the question and answer from the book, from the same chapter number 10, and I had given these MCQs. Choose the correct answer. It was also written, choose the correct option.
But there was no question was not written over there.
Choose the correct answer from the given options. So you have to see the question from the book. I has explained you that see the question, that it is written in the book. You have to select the correct answer. So I had explained this thing in the previous classes and this problem was discussed in the previous classes, just like first option is there, that for dash twinning, the drawing object has to be converted into symbol. For motion twin, we convert the object, whatever we have drawn, the drawing into symbol, and then we apply the twin motion.
Okay, I see. Okay, sir, I understand.
So now I will also mention the page number as well, if you say. So on page 159, it is given.
No, it's okay.
Okay, so I had explained this thing. And you will find out its explanation in, I think, third last or fourth last class, the explanation was given. But since it was not the day of the homework, so I did not give at that day. Now, yesterday I have given, and today I have again given one homework. This is the short question. Can you see in the red color? This is a short question that I have given. How can you identify a key phrase?
Is it from page 159, this one too?
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Okay.
Page 160. Page 160, it is available. The exercise.
Yeah, this question is available on page 160.
How can you identify a frame in the timeline? Okay.
Okay.
Dua Atif.
Sir, please, can you tell me how to use F6 in laptop?
F6, F6.
It doesn't work in my laptop. F6.
Then there would be some problem with your laptop. Otherwise, in laptops as well, F1, F2 keys are given at the top.
Sir, but it's not given in my laptop.
Function keys are not there in your laptop.
Sir, can you show me?
You can use, then in that situation, you can use insert frame. F6, and I think it is given over here. Insert keyframe. Yeah, you can give command from here. Insert timeline. Here is F5. Frame.
Okay.
For keyframe, you will click on it. You see here, for frame F5, for keyframe F6. So if you don't have F5, F6, go there and press over here using mouse. But it will be quite time consuming if you don't have the F6, F5 keys, because every time you will have to go to the insert menu, timeline, and then you will go to frame, insert keyframe, and then you will click, then it will be called basically F6. You have pressed F6.
Okay, thank you, sir.
You're welcome. Yes, Daniel.
Yes, sir. I wanted to say that. Can we also just use the paint bucket tool to fill the tree inside of the tree?
Yeah, we can. It's up to you. Drawing is entirely up to you. I have left it up to you. How, whatever you draw, basically it depends person to person. The drawing capacity is basically a person's own capacity, that how much he has good at drawing, what is his aesthetic sense. According to that, you have to draw. Okay. No problem at all. What tool you are using? You are using pencil, you are using brush, you are using any other drawing tool, line tool, whatever you are using. It does not
matter. I used to prefer the primitive oval tool.
Okay, fine. Ibrahim. I have unmuted you.
Sorry, sir. I accidentally raised my hand.
Aris.
Yes, sir. I just wanted to say that I will, inshallah, do the assignment, and I have submitted the homework too.
Okay, fine. I make this scenery as well and submit it, okay?
Yes, I'll make it by hand.
Okay.
And I want to ask that the scenery that we have to make it as a background.
Yeah, I have shown you some examples. You can take any of such kind of whatever you want to draw. You can take any sample and you can draw, just like trees, plants, water, hearts, something like that. Just like this one is quite, I think, quite easy. Not that much difficult, okay? Fine?
Yes.
Okay, so... our class time is now about 2 hours. If you have got anything to ask, you can ask me, and I will put this assignment over here with the name of lab activities. You can submit it over here. Yes, Rimsha.
Yes, sir. Sir, when I am using paint bucket tool in Flash, it's not working.
It will only work if you have got one enclosed shape. Yes, it will not work on the shape which is not closed. For example, if I draw it in this way and it is not closed. If I take the paint bucket and I try to draw it over here, paint bucket, and I try to drop the paint here, it is not working, fine? So when I will have a shape like this shape, I am drawing, which is closed shape. Then I will take the paint bucket tool with some color and I drop the paint, it is working.
Sir, I have tried this, but it's not working.
Select the color from here. Select the color that you want to fill. It will work, of course. You will not face any problem.
Okay.
If the color is not selected and it is coming white, so let's suppose. And I am pressing here. You are able to see that it is giving you white color. So people think that it is not working. But when you will select the color and you will drop that color, so it will, of course, work. It will show you the output.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
You're welcome, Rimsha. Rimsha, we have only, I think, last minute. I want to, I had unmuted you, but you did not say anything. Okay. Thank you so much, all of you. I hope you are going to do the practice for it, inshallah. And you will make good animation and you make this scenery as well, okay? And I will give you in the Google Classroom, submit it over there. Thank you so much.